your jersey. Shannon, do you like it? What do you make of this?
You just got to accept it, Skip. This is who he is. This is what you tell me, Skip. You say you and Jenny have told me he's that fiery guy. He's going to do this thing. He's going to say things a certain way. And this is who he is. You have to accept it. Do I want my quarterback shotgunning beers in public? I don't know if I want any of my players shotgunning beers in public. I mean, Skip, it's like, I'm sure, look, we have a hierarchy here at Fox. I'm sure Fox would not be pleased if any of their employees was on camera shotgunning beers, Skip, regardless of the importance of that player, let alone Shanks. Let alone Charlie Dixon or someone like that, Skip. So basically, he's the face of your franchise, and he's shotgunning beers on camera. But this is who he is, Skip. This is what you have to accept of him. You would the Browns like less of this? I'm sure. Because, Skip, you know how it goes. You've been around this thing for 40-plus years. The quarterback is critiqued differently. They're looked at differently. They're judged differently. And so things that, like Bakhtiari, because I think he started this trend at a Bucs game when he chugged two and then, you know, he pointed at Aaron Rodgers and Rodgers got through half of one. And the next thing you know, here's Matthew Stafford. And then you had other guys doing it. Linemen do it.
Chugging out of cups. Yeah. Right?
True.
But, yeah, they didn't puncture the can with a tooth and then do it like that, Skip. Skip, that's a whole... I thought you said he's from, like, well, you know, Highland Park or somewhere.
Skip, not Highland Park, but he came from somewhere.
Yeah!
I don't know how to do that. I would not do that.
Old Skip Baylor special right there. Old Skip Baylor special. Now, they call that a Bayless. Now, when you bite the can and start chugging, they call that a Bayless.
Diet, dude.
Yeah.
I got to tell you, I love this. This is the essence of Baker Mayfield. Remember, this was spontaneous, extemporaneous, spur of moment, inspirational, detonating leadership from this guy at a baseball game.
Right.
Not for the Browns, for the Indians.
Yes.
It wasn't planned. He didn't rehearse it.
No.
He just suddenly looks up and thinks, wait. I'm on TV.
Right.
Throw me another can.
Right.
Somebody flips him a can, and he doesn't just pop the top.
Right.
He bit into the side and opened it with his teeth. I've never seen that before.
Seen that. No.
Have you?
No.
I mean, I don't drink beer, so I don't know how hard is it to bite through that can. He's Jaws from James Bond, right?
Yeah, exactly.
I know.
I ain't biting. Not with E right here.
No. Who would risk that?
No.
And not only does he successfully bite into the can as if he's done it numerous times before, it spews and sprays and he guzzles it. And then he immediately spins and points to his Lindor jersey.
Right.
Yeah.
The score is nothing to nothing going into the bottom of the fifth. What immediately happened? The Indians scored 5 runs. Who hit a 3-run homer in the bottom of the fifth?
Francisco Lindor.
Yep.
It's a fairy tale. It's a storybook. It is Baker Mayfield. This is why I told you before the draft, I'm taking him first overall. What did Hugh Jackson say when he went to Oklahoma to work him out? He walked into the locker room and he heard Baker doing this weird whistle to some of the receivers who were there.
Right.
He said, he's the Pied Piper.
Right.
He just has this leadership charisma.
Right.
I've never seen anything quite like it. Players respond to that.
Right.
Does the front office, does the ownership respond to that? Probably not.
Right.
Unless it translates into winning playoff games and maybe a Super Bowl.
Skip, Baker Mayfield is what we would call a party starter. You go to a party and nobody's doing anything. Ain't nobody dancing. Ain't nobody doing anything. Everybody's just sitting around. And then Baker's talking about shot, shot, shot. And everybody taking shots. And next thing you know, the dance floor crowded. You see right there, everybody's dragging. If you, like you said, it's the fifth inning.
True.
Nothing ball game. There's no excitement going on. And then all of a sudden, on the video board, you see Baker Mayfield. He bites into a can of beer. He chugs it. The crowd goes electric.
Crazy.
Now the guys in the dugout going crazy. And bam, next thing you know, the Indians win the ball game. Lindor is the hero. And Baker has on a Lindor jersey.
I've always said Cleveland at heart, is a Browns town.
Yeah.
It's a football town. It's going back to Jim Brown days.
Yes.
It's what they used to know and they're still clinging to. And he gives them that hope.
Right.
So he goes to the baseball game and detonates the crowd, and the Browns fans are saying, we got Baker.
Yep.
That's good.
Skip, if you didn't know better, he's a Cleveland is a blue collar town. They got the dog pound. Nobody else has. I mean, the dog pound. Come on. Mm-mm. He's as good a representative of that at the quarterback position as anywhere. Now, I don't know what they call it. They have a name for what they call any other stadium, but nothing like this.
It's the black hole.
Not
the closest thing. But that's different.
That's very different.
There are a lot of doctors and dentists in the black hole dressed up like it's Halloween.
They got on shoulder pads and face paint. I'm like, hold on, for real? Because I thought they let San Quentin out for a day. That's what I thought those guys were. Mm. But lo and behold, they did a story on them. They're doctors, they're lawyers. They're like, I'm like, huh? Mm. Really? But Skip, he is as good a representative of what Cleveland Browns football and Cleveland Brown fans, the interaction that they have, is that they've had it a very, very long time.
Okay.
And so I'm sure management, I don't know, John Dorsey probably not going to call him in. the Haslam, Jimmy and D, that's not their red cup of tea. But like you said, if it equate to wins, guess what? Mm-hmm. You'll be at another Indians game.
That is correct.
And you'll be doing it again.
So here's the ultimate test of Baker Mayfield. Odell Beckham Jr., who says they're going to be scary when they start to click. Can Baker's it factor overcome Odell's me factor? Can his charisma overcome Odell's egomania? Mm-hmm. I have my doubts.
Right.
Only because Odell is already so much bigger than Baker.
Right.
Odell did it in the Big Apple. Mm-hmm. Odell's still a little raw about getting pushed out the back door in the Big Apple. Odell's still trying to get comfortable and make peace with having to do it way out there in Cleveland, Ohio, even though we did see him in a little video that got posted. He stopped and signed a license tag because all is well in Odell's world for the moment.
Correct.
They haven't even played a preseason game yet. Mm-hmm. So Odell is 4 years ahead. Well, he's played six, so he's actually 5 years ahead of Baker. Mm-hmm. And I just don't know if Baker can bring Odell into the fold of sacrificing for the team to try to be all for one and one for all. I just don't know. It's going to be a clash of big personalities, Baker versus Odell.
Skip, I don't know. It won't be for lack of trying, because Baker's personality is a lot different than Eli, where if Odell stepped what we would consider stepping over the line or on the line, Eli would just, that's not my responsibility, let the coach handle
it. Shrug and go on.
I believe Baker would be like, Odell, what are you doing?
Oh, it will be confrontational.
Will you cut that bull drive out?
That's what he'll say.
We've seen that.
We have seen a little bit.
I think that personality, and I think that's what Odell needs in the beginning. And he's like, you know what? You're right, dog. Let's go get this touchdown.
Okay. Well, is that going to keep happening in October, November, and December? I don't know. I just have my doubts that Odell can make peace with that, what you're talking about.
Right.
But if anybody can bring him down one notch to a team notch, Baker Mayfield can. So whatever that thing was you saw on display in the Indians game, that's what Odell's going to get, double-barreled shotgun right in the face, right? And then here we'll go. We'll see how it works.
Party starter. I feel like you're probably the party starter, Shannon.
You know, I do a little something. I do a little something. Do a little something.
Do a little dance.
I need a little something. Huh? It was kind of like we're in the Hall. Well, you didn't see it, but, you know, normally we go to the Hall of Fame, Skip. It's always Michael and I. You know, well, you know Michael.
Oh, boy.
You know I know Michael. So it's always going to be something when he and I get together.
Get that party started.
We saw some good videos. I'm sure some of it you can't share on TV.
No.
But good memories. So Ezekiel Elliott, is he going to miss regular season games for the Cowboys? Eric Dickerson is here. Let's get his take next.